Amen.
Thank you very much. I'm a retired, I'm very, very loyal for you, very young people. Not a lie. And coming to experience today reminds me of how important it is to stay alive, not only just to life, but to the life of other people, in this case, the people of one of the third world countries, which you do so well. This is a good thing that you're doing here. A good thing. You know, give any message to the young people, the more adults you hear, I've heard this before, of course. And for the young people, look for good things in life, participate and make things good as well. That's really what we're attempting to try to do. The mural was wholly without the blessing. The blessing just makes extra for it. It was wholly because of what it drew from you and what it reminded you of your experiences in the South. So I thank you for being here, and I thank you for having me being here and letting me see something that's
that's the other side of the just so you know, I knew Mr. Connolly when he weighed almost 150 pounds to his current 110. We had a WECTA, and that's the teachers' union. There's 44,000 teachers in this province of Catholic schools. But one of the things the members told us, very important that we represent and be involved in social justice. We do that through a couple of ways. One way is we help support the North-South Awareness, but Brenda missed a couple of ripple effects. One ripple effect, and I'll give you the sort of story. For most of us, we will get involved in our society by giving a donation. How many people have given a donation of some sort? Some of us might say, you know what, I'm going to help out. I can be that good Samaritan. I'm going to get off that donkey, and I'm going to help somebody. That's the service part. Might be a food kitchen, it might be somewhere like that capacity. The next one's the tough one. And this school has attempted to get you to move to the next one. Well, the ripple effect is my son got it on an exchange program to St. Augustine's. Because this school decided it wasn't good enough to keep this secret. That the only way you're going to make a change is if you get other people involved. So St. Augustine's got involved. My son is here. It changed the way he looked at his future. It changed what he took at university, and it changed his disposition and his outlook. That's the educational model. That's where agents of change come out of. What you do, what you're reflecting here, in this mural, look at the words on it. Respect, justice, peace, no more violence, solidarity. All language we use, but I bet you it means a lot different. Nicaragua. And let's not be arrogant enough to think we're here to help Nicaragua. We've got to be open and have that eye open and that heart open. We've got to be prepared to have Nicaragua teach us a few things. That's what exchange means. That's what a lot of things do. Now I understand, maybe I'm wrong, but this mural is portable.
That's correct.
So it can be commissioned and moved somewhere else, is that correct? I'm going to ask that it be moved to our annual general meeting next March, when over 1,000 teachers from across the province get together to make decisions about policies and directions for this association, who has a really keen interest in social justice, a real keen interest in moving things along. As Archbishop Albert Kamara once said, when you help somebody, they call you a saint. But when you ask why people are poor, they call you a communist. When you move from doing those daily duties and you start to ask the question, let this mural be your portal, not just to Nicaragua, but to be be asking those questions of fundamental change that is necessary in our society. We have issues of respect, issues of justice, issues of peace. We have violence and domestic violence. We share a common thread there, ladies and gentlemen. I'd ask you every time you look at this mural that that's going to be your gateway, your doorway, and reflecting into those things. It's made a profound change for me and my son. It also made a profound change for me because of this school. I stole their program. Yes, I am a father. I stole the program. I took a group of at-risk students to Costa Rica.
I was Robert Lynn, engineer, Kevin. And interesting, when you look at the two murals here on this wall, the top mural versus the second mural. The school that we were when we first opened 20 years ago, we're celebrating that next year with our first reunion. Interesting that the accessories along the table have now become the predominant colors. And that's what we've become. We've become a caring Catholic community, reaching out in Canada, the Toronto area, reaching out across to Central America to people who need that care. And I can see people like Melissa Grillo and people who graduated the very first years from our school. I can see them in that mural. And I can see Rosario's students in that mural. They're there. We can't see them visibly, but the care and love that they have is there. Just when they look at the projects that we've worked on in Nicaragua, the wells that we've dug, the schools that we've built, the homes that we've worked to construct for them, our students are still there. And that's the beauty of that kind of social justice involvement that I have to look at Gary and laugh at it. Like Kevin, I can remember Gary back at Carver Leche in the mid-80s doing different things, but he led this project. So now it's passed on to the students and the following generations. That won't be our last mural. The challenge is, where will the next mural come from? Who will do the artistry? And what will it mean to our RFHall community? There are a lot of people who have contributed to that. Our teachers, our parents, our students, administrators, trustees. We should be very proud of that work. I look at it now and I can still see those pieces that I painted on there. I'm just happy they didn't mess it up. Because if I was creating that mural, I'd say it was
In closing, I'd like to say a huge thank you on behalf of the staff and students here, to our parents and guardians, the people of Nicaragua, the people in the organizations of Funarte and Catholic Investing in Nicaragua. All of these people have been affected by the solidarity and justice work that we're able to do together. So thank you to the Catholic Education Foundation of Ontario, Dr. Peel Catholic District School Board, Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association, and most especially, thank you to Rosario. In closing, I want to just share the final lines of a message that was written to young Catholics on social justice from the Canadian Catholic Conference of Bishops that was published last September. And this is what they wrote. We invite you, as young Catholics, to be witnesses of Christ's love in the world and to raise awareness of global issues in light of the Church's social teaching through involvement in various Catholic social justice agencies and as active members of your parishes, student associations, and other movements. So thank you to the young people here today who are living that day in, day out. Thank you very much. Blueberry shortly for some refreshments for the David Harris and his family and staff members. Before we do that, I want to say a huge thank you to Mr. Lloyd and the band. But Mr. Lloyd spent hours here, countless hours, setting this up and preparing this. Thank you very much for all your hard work. It's going to be a
one more second. Smile.
Well, we need to get it to Peter.
I thought.